Welcome back to the School of Airway. Now we're going to discuss stance. How do you stand? Alright. I don't do an outhouse stance of defecation. I don't do this. I don't do a buffalo stance. I almost use Bruce Lee-like fighting stance. So I can lean forward, lean back, get taller when I'm trying to integrate with taller residents or students, or I can squat and get lower when I have shorter residents or colleagues of mine that are trying to integrate and I'm trying to assist. Okay? Not everyone positions the patients correctly, but that's another topic, another blog cast video that I provided already on the School of Airway. Okay? So, how do I intubate? Just like this. For those who don't understand, I will slowly rotate. Right. I keep my arm in one position, right, against my torso, and it becomes a lever. Right. Hope I can demonstrate to you how I intubate. Right? So, proceed to intubate like so. Right. I'm by myself. I will squat correctly, lean over, open the mouth, it is on, the light source that works, and I'll proceed with intubation. Okay? Believe you me, it's in. There are some of you that may not believe me, I'm telling you it's in. Again, I know some of you won't believe me. So I will demonstrate the exaggerated chest rise. This position is doable. This stance is doable. Not impossible. I'm not saying you have to fight. I'm just saying get ready in the stance. Get ready stance. All right? Please try not to intubate with Huntington's chorea. Alright? Or ballism, alright? The more you start using your other arms, your other muscles of the arms and moving around, you'll tire out the arm and you won't be able to intubate. You'll have to give the intubation away. Okay?
Your attention, please. Your attention.
Thank you.